in New York Harbor. There's an island called Governor's Island. And it looks like an ice cream cone from the air. And all of the old colonial buildings are in the ice cream part. And then the cone was like the parade grounds, and all these barracks used to be on it. And they were built, I think, originally around the Civil War. So they were trying to figure out what to do with these buildings, and they decided what they would do is tear them all down and crush them all up. Now, how do you vegetate them? It's crushed up rubble from buildings. How do you put plants on there and make it actually grow and look beautiful? So that was kind of the charge that they put out. And one of my advisors, Todd Harrington, answered the challenge. So working with a large landscape company, they brought in some engineered soil. And when Todd told me that one, I kind of rolled my eyes and went, right, that's engineered dirt. Call it what it is. There is no biology in that stuff at all.
So this particular contract at Governor's Island required to achieve certain biological numbers at the end of the contract. So I think it was a 2-year contract for them. They had to have certain expected ranges biologically in their engineered soils before they left the contract for them to get fully paid, which was good because it basically forced them to hire someone like me to consult with them, and it forced them to basically do all the testing, which a lot of companies don't want to spend the money or the time doing. A project like this should really be 3 to 5 years, and we only had 2.
And they leveled off the top of these hills, and they had some nice elevation, you know, sharp cliffs and rolling cliffs and stuff. And so now, here you go. We want a native grassland here, and we want a conifer forest, and we want a deciduous forest, and we want this kind of shrubbery here. We want these native plants here. And so they, you know, the architect had all the plants drawn in, and now you have to go out there and establish that. Well, most of us know that if you tried to do that on engineered dirt, that it would be utter failure, that there would just be massive erosion, and most of the engineered dirt that had been put on the top of the rubble underneath is just gonna wash off into the ocean, into the harbor on all sides. It'd just be horrific.
We did a lot more applications than normal, mostly because we had such a short period of time on the project. For example, we might do typically 3 applications in a year for a project like this, where we probably did like 10 in a year. So we're really aggressive about getting that biology in that really horrible engineered soil. I gotta say it was a real challenge because it wasn't much of a monoculture, it was a polyculture of many different plant species. I came into the project knowing this, and so one of the things that I did is we sourced out lots of different composts, lots of different foods. So it wasn't like your basic 1 or 2 compost sources. I sourced out probably about 5 to 10 different types of compost. So there was a lot of, and I'm gonna use this word a few times, diversity.
So Todd, looking at this, said he's gonna apply biological principles, so a food web approach. And so made compost for each of those ecosystems with the biology in it for each of the sets of plants that were desired in that area. So there were big areas of grassland and native grasslands, and there was a ballpark, and so all of the biology going on to these places either is compost, and so he's putting in all of the biology that needs to go into those systems.
So there's a lot of diversity in the compost that we used, and there was a lot of diversity in the food sources that we used for the compost and the liquid compost. So that way, because there were so many different plants in the project, there was a lot to select from. Think of it as a smorgasbord. You know, just about everything was in the compost or the liquid compost for all the different plant species, versus very, you know, kind of narrowing it down to just maybe woody ornamentals or maybe an old growth forest versus maybe a vegetable garden. With, you can get more specific and dialed in for that kind of a biology, where this is like, you know, all over the board, from ground cover to grasses and forbs to woody ornamentals. So it was pretty broad range. And another important factor in this project was at the early stages, I sat down with the entire team. Any and every single person that was involved in that project was in the meeting. And that was really important to have all the people there involved. And I took them through the whole process, and we put together a field guide for them on this entire process, from the equipment to the applications, to the testing and what the testing meant, and how we were going to modify the program if needed based on the testing that we were doing.
And so today when you go to this area, people from New York City flock there on weekends because it's beautiful. They're back in conifer forests, they're back in deciduous forests, they're in the native grasslands. So within the course of basically one growing season, they took this horrific dirt, and by the addition of this biology, they could put in all of the plants and natives.
In this particular project, I think what I learned mostly was how to be organized. Because I've never done so much testing within such a short period of time. The other thing I learned is also, I guess this project didn't have a lot of time, you know, and so being really aggressive with the program really paid off in the results. It's really satisfying, especially knowing we did it without any chemicals and pesticides. And it's actually, you know, proof of Dr. Elaine's work that she's been doing for decades. Long as you follow through the process, and you do the testing. We have all the data, and that's important because there's a lot of skeptics out there, the chemical guys, the landscapers that have been doing this for decades with chemicals. But if you've got the data there, then it can back you up, and you can explain to them why it looks the way it does and how it works because you actually have that data.